Welcome to the 340th Flying Training Group Undergraduate Flying Training Program page. My name is Technical Sergeant Lovesey, and in this video, I will cover how to file your Permanent Change of Station or PCS vouchers. Prior to your PCS, please ensure you complete self-counseling requirements in Move.mil. Your Move.mil account was established when you in-process here at JBSA-Randolph. To determine if you are on a PCS order, review Section 27 of your Air Force Form 938. If a line of accounting is displayed for household goods and PCS, you are on a PCS order. If a line of accounting is displayed for travel and per diem, you are not on a PCS order. If a line of accounting is displayed for pay and allowances only, you are not on a PCS order. Also, please check for line of accounting information on all order modifications if applicable. You may submit two vouchers each time you PCS. The first voucher is titled PCS Voucher Mileage and TLE, or PCS Voucher Mileage Only if TLE was not used. This voucher will reimburse mileage for you and dependents listed on your order, temporary lodging expense, also known as TLE, and dislocation allowance, also known as DLA if eligible. The second voucher is titled PPM Voucher. This voucher will reimburse your household goods movement and authorized moving expenses. Your PCS voucher must be submitted to the 340th UFT workflow inbox within 5 workdays after completion of travel. Please refer to the 340th UFT Pay Roadmap, Column C and F, and the 340th UFT SharePoint Templates link for downloadable templates. As a reminder, you downloaded these templates to your personal computer when you in-processed here at JBSA-Randolph. Before you complete your voucher, you must first determine which templates apply to your situation. If you stayed in TLE, use the PCS voucher, mileage, and TLE template. You are authorized 10 days of TLE each time you PCS. If you are in between training courses, you are authorized a total of 10 days at either your training location or your next PCS location, or a combination of both, as long as you remain on a PCS order. If you did not stay in TLE, use the PCS voucher mileage only template. Now, let's get started on your DD Form 1351-2 PCS mileage voucher with or without TLE. In Block 1, place an X in the electronic fund transfer box. Read the split disbursement statement, place an X in the box, and add the dollar amount to be paid directly to your government travel card, also known as the GTC. Please confirm your GTC balance and ensure the amount annotated will cover your balance. Next, for blocks 2 through 4 and 6 through 7, fill out the highlighted areas with your personal information. If you are prior service and meet O1E requirements, write O1E in block 3. Block 5 will determine your DLA payment. If your dependents accompany you to your PCS location and they are listed on your PCS order, you are eligible for DLA at the dependent rate. If you are single with no dependents and you are on your first PCS, such as to your undergraduate training location, you are not eligible for DLA. If you are single with no dependents and you are on your second PCS, such as after completing your undergraduate training course, you are eligible for DLA at the single rate. Please note, if you're submitting a BAH waiver and you qualify in the single category and the same rules will apply, please review our BAH waiver video for eligibility requirements. Also, DLA is not authorized for any student who is PCSing back to their home of record. You may need to meet additional JTR requirements to get DLA. Place an X in the DLA box if you are eligible and an X in the dependent box if applicable. Next, enter your travel order number in Block 8. This number can be found in Block 32 of your Air Force Form 938. Leave Blocks 9 and 10 blank. Enter 340th FTG JBSA-Randolph as your organization and station for Block 11. Block 12 will reimburse mileage and authorize entitlements for all dependents listed on your PCS order. Place an X in the accompanied box if your dependents did PCS with you and are listed on your order. Place an X in the unaccompanied box if your dependents did not PCS with you or if you are single with no dependents. List the name, relationship, and date of birth of your authorized dependents in Block 12A through C. Leave Block 13 blank. in Block 14, place an X in the applicable box concerning your household goods shipment. If you are completing a personally procured move, also known as DIDI or do-it-yourself move, mark no. If you use professional movers to move your household goods, mark yes. Next, refer to the itinerary paragraph on your Air Force Form 938 when completing Section 15. List the current year in Block 15A. List the first day of travel to the left of the departure block and the location you are PCSing from to the right of the departure block. This information should match the itinerary paragraph of your Air Force Form 938. Most students will PCS using their private automobile. List PA under column C under means mode of travel. If you were required to fly to your PCS location because you are traveling from overseas, list CP for commercial plane. Next, list the last day of travel to the left of the arrival block and your PCS location to the right of the arrival block. This information should match the itinerary paragraph of your Air Force Form 938. In column D, list MC, mission complete. For reason for stop, leave column E and F blank. Do not list each stop along the way. Only list the initial departure location and the final arrival location. In block 16, place an X in the own operate box. In block 17, place an X in the more than 24 hours box. In block 18A, write the date listed on your TLE lodging receipt. In block 18B, write temporary lodging expense in the nature of expense column. In block 18C, write the dollar amount charged for TLE. This receipt amount must match your TLE receipt. Also, if your spouse drove a separate vehicle, write claiming second vehicle on the second line of the nature of expense column. Leave block 18D blank. TLE expenses will not be reimbursed on the travel days listed in the itinerary paragraph of your Air Force Form 938. You will receive a daily flat rate for per diem and lodging for all PCS travel days. Therefore, receipts for lodging while traveling to your PCS location are not required. To ensure all entitlements are reimbursed, travel in accordance with the itinerary paragraph listed on your Air Force Form 938. Leave blocks 19A and B blank. Sign block 20A and date block 20B. Now, let's look at supporting documents you must submit with your DD Form 1351-2. A list of these documents can also be found on the second page of your template. First, you will need a copy of your PCS order along with all order modifications. Log into your Aeros R account to download your order. Next, if TLE was used, download a DD Form 9098 from the 340th UFT SharePoint template link and complete it in accordance with your TLE lodging receipt. Also, submit your TLE lodging receipt and, if applicable, a non-availability letter. Finally, submit your airline ticket if you flew to your PCS location. Submit all supporting documents along with your DD Form 1351-2 as a single PDF to the 340th UFT workflow inbox for processing. Call the 340th UFT office to ensure your voucher was received. This completes the requirements for your PCS mileage voucher with or without TLE. Now, let's get started on a separate DD Form 1351-2 for your PPM voucher. This voucher will reimburse the movement of your household goods and approved moving expenses. Please refer to the PPM voucher template as we go through this process. Complete all blocks the same as you did on your PCS mileage voucher, except the following blocks. Block 5, place an X in the PCS box. Section 15, handwrite PPM, write total expenses in block 18B. Do not list each expense, dates, or dollar amounts. Expenses will be reimbursed in accordance with your submitted receipts. Now, let's look at supporting documents you must submit with your DD Form 1351-2 for your PPM voucher. A list of these documents can be found on the second page of your template. First, you will need a copy of your PCS order along with all order modifications. Log into your Aeros R account to download your order. Next, a certified DD Form 2278 application for do-it-yourself move is required. Visit the Traffic Management Office, also known as TMO, at your PCS location to have a representative certify your DD Form 2278. You may be required to drop off your documents with a TMO representative to review and pick up your documents at a later time. If so, please explain to the TMO representative that your documents must be submitted to the 340th UFT workflow inbox for payment due to funding requirements. To avoid a potential debt, do not process documents through your PCS location finance office. Next, download a PPM checklist from the 340th UFT SharePoint templates link. Ensure all items on the checklist are completed and list approved PCS expenses are supported by receipts. Sign and date the checklist. Don't forget to submit your weight receipts, authorized rental receipts, and all claimable receipts. If you have any questions on what is or is not reimbursable, please call TMO. TMO contact information will be provided to you once you complete self-counseling in move.mil. Submit all supporting documents along with your DD form 1351-2 as a single PDF to the 340th UFT workflow inbox for processing. Call the 340th UFT office to ensure your voucher was received. This will complete the requirements for your PPM voucher. Once you confirm that your vouchers were received, please wait 10 business days before you check for a status update. An itemized reimbursement breakdown of your vouchers will be available to you on your advice of payment link in your MyPay account. Also, log into your city bank account to ensure your split disbursement payment was received. This concludes our PCS voucher process guidance. If you find this video helpful, please don't forget to click the subscribe button so that you will be notified when we upload new videos. Additional videos with helpful information will soon be available on our YouTube channel. Thank you for making the time to review this video. Again, I'm Technical Sergeant Levesey, and we look forward to assisting you.